Hello everyone, this is ICO Talk. My name is Yelena. Today my guest is Michael J. Garbade, founder of LiveEdu. Hello Michael, thanks for joining us today.
Hi, nice to be on your show.
Okay, so first of all, please tell us a few words about the project. What is it all about and what is the main idea behind it?
Right, so the name of our project is LiveEdu, and LiveEdu is a project learning platform that teaches people how to build products and thereby improve their job skills in certain future technologies. So what we do is like, unlike the other existing online education platform, is that we kind of like put our focus on people who are intermediates to experts. And also the main difference between our product and existing product is that we teach people how to build a product, right? So we are more focused on building a complete product. That means building like, let's say an AI bot, or building like artificial intelligence radar, right? So we don't teach people like basics. We are not focused on beginner content, beginner stuff. And the way we teach people how to build stuff is by using like real projects, right? So we have like real projects that people kind of like use on our platform. They kind of like download project resources and they can kind of like practice with those projects. So our product is just about projects.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and will you please tell us more about the role of blockchain in this?
Right, so what we do is actually we are using ERC20 tokens, right? We are using ERC20 tokens on our ecosystem. Uh-huh. We're using it for payments, we're using it for rewards, and we're using it for incentives, right?
So the role of blockchain is just the tokens, yes?
So we are an app blockchain company. For now, we are not building our own protocol. Right, we are not building our own protocol. We are using the Ethereum protocol for now.
Okay.
In about 3 years, we will start building our own protocol. But we don't need our own protocol like immediately, right? We don't need it immediately because our main focus is building up our internal ecosystem and our external ecosystem.
Okay.
So our internal ecosystem is the first job we need to kind of crack, and we would need the external our own protocol when we are building our external ecosystem.
Okay.
So our internal ecosystem, it consists of one, project creators, people who are creating projects, and then people who want to watch those projects. It consists of community moderators, and it consists of API developers. Mm-hmm. So that's like our internal ecosystem. That's like our smaller ecosystem. And this is the ecosystem which we are building to kind of like create like tons of projects. Right, for the 8 topics we cover. So for the 8 topics that we cover, the vision that we have is we want to kind of like build like a huge number of projects that people can kind of like practice, right? And okay. We cover like artificial intelligence. We cover also like data science. We cover cryptocurrencies. We cover AI. We cover VR. We cover also AI. And so for the beginning, we are launching our ecosystem with 8 topics, right? But in 2019, we are going to open up our ecosystem for like all topics, right?
Okay.
But for the beginning, we are starting with 8 topics.
Okay, and tell us just a bit more about the story of the project. When was it launched and who's got the idea of it, and why have you decided to develop this particular idea?
Right. Actually, our story is a bit different than most ICO projects because like we started off as a Y Combinator company, right? We went through Y Combinator. And we were building a product called Live Coding. And Live Coding was similar to the product we were building, but it was more focused on software development and people building like casual, like just streaming casually while they are working on, right?
Okay.
And we just realized that there is a bigger market and a bigger product to what we are doing, right? If we focus on structured projects, that means projects that people can learn with, right?
Yeah.
And if we use like certain aspects of the blockchain, certain aspects of tokenization, we can build a bigger business. We can build an ecosystem around it, right? We can build for online education, or STEAMIT build for publishing, right?
Mm-hmm.
So all we are doing is very similar to STEAMIT. So STEAMIT, just we're using a lot of the token mechanics, a lot of the business logic and models that STEAMIT is doing for content publishing. We are taking the same concept. We are taking the same logic and the things that work for them pretty well. And we are basically building like the STEAMIT for online education, right?
Mm-hmm.
So we have like project creators and we have people who want to kind of like watch and learn from those projects. So we have like a classic marketplace model similar to STEAMIT.
Oh, okay. But still, what are your main advantages and the main differences over other projects?
Okay, so if you will compare us to other projects or other products that exist, the ecosystem that we are building, you can compare us to YouTube, a bit of YouTube. We are like a hybrid of YouTube and a hybrid of lynda.com and Pluralsight, like a hybrid of these two, like Lynda and YouTube. This is like a real hybrid of it, right? So Twitch took like gaming out of YouTube, right? It took gaming out of YouTube and built it into a huge business. Okay. And we are taking online education out of YouTube and want to build it into a huge business, right? Mm-hmm. So the advantage compared to YouTube in terms of YouTube is one, we are very focused on online education, right? We're very focused on this category. And second, the projects that we are building, right, on YouTube, you might find like one video or two, right? We are building like complete projects where you have like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, the whole complete session, right?
Yeah.
And third, the projects on LiveEdu, they are well structured and they have also like project resources you can download, right? So they are kind of like download the whole project files, right? And the projects on LiveEdu also is like, it's built around a community that's very focused on learning, right? We have like people who are really like interested in the topics that they are working on, right? And the community is very different than a community that's just playing music or watching cat videos, right? The people who are very, very much into their topics and they know their topics, right? It's like we are building a community that's very focused and very sharply focused on what they are working on. And fourthly, because the project creators are paid, they are incentivized to really create like projects that are of high quality, because otherwise people will run them low and they will be removed from the system, right? So in terms of YouTube, that's the main difference. Compared to lynda.com, LiveEdu is just focused on projects. We are about projects, projects, projects. We are building the biggest project library in the world. Like if you want to learn anything and you're thinking of, hey, I want to get some practical skills, not just theory or like, you know, basic stuff, you want to really build stuff, you want to be like the place on the web, right, for projects. That's like what we are building, right? And third, we focus on topics that are very much like future technologies, right? That means topics that are not well defined yet, where you will not find any content for it online right now, right? So topics like artificial intelligence. You're not going to find like any platform or online education platform that offers you like a huge load of, you know, projects on these topics or like content. AI, VR, all these topics are covered online, but they are very theoretical and basics that are covered online. And we are coming in and we're just like, okay, let's take it to a whole new level and offer people like real practical, like knowledge, real practical projects. And we are very much focused on intermediates to experts. That's very important. We don't focus on people who are like new to the field and want to learn. So if somebody is like very green, our product is not that for that person, right? Because the users on our platform are college students and professionals working already in the industry. Okay. They know their tools, they know their stuff, they already use them every day, and all they care about is improving their skills. Right, so LiveEdu is like a place where you kind of like improve the skills you have. You don't start to learn new skills. You kind of like improve what you build on top of what you have.
Right? I see. Great. Sounds great. Yeah. Okay. Now, just a few words about the team of the project, please.
Right. So we are a team of like 10 people, right? And the core team is like 3 people. It's like me, Alex, and Ilya, right? So we are kind of like build a whole product ourselves, our whole streaming cluster. We are very highly technical. Our streaming cluster spans like 3 areas. We have like a streaming cluster in Asia, we have a streaming cluster in Europe, in London, and we have a streaming cluster in US. And what we are building is actually, we cover the video architecture, we cover also like the education side. And Alex is like a general developer, he does the website, Ilya does the front end side, and I do mainly like the streaming architecture and everything business related. Right.
Okay.
So compared to other ICOs, I think we are a smaller team.
Not very big, yeah.
Smaller team, not that big. But we like that because it gives us flexibility to kind of like build and without a lot of politics.
Okay. Let's now speak a little bit more about the ICO. So first of all, please tell us about the soft cap and the hard cap.
Right. So we have a soft cap of 1 million and we have a hard cap of 10 million. Right, and the hard cap of 10 million would count all contribution types. Contribution can be ETH or BTC, right? So we could count all contributions toward it. We decided to go for a low hard cap ICO because we wanted to have discipline like, you know, and just like not raising too much.
Yeah, because the 10 million is not that much comparatively to other.
Exactly, other ICOs, and we just we know that what we can build with 10 million. Just want to keep it like that and be disciplined and build, like, you know, not just raise money for raising sake, but just really use to build the product we plan to build.
Okay, you've mentioned already about some milestones of the roadmap, but still tell us more. What for do you need this particular sum, and what are the key milestones of development of the project?
Right, so the key milestones of development is, one, we are going to release the new version of our platform, right? And the new version of our platform will be kind of like integrate the whole tokens into our product, right? We're going to integrate like the education tokens into our product. We are running a utility ICO, so the tokens are used on our platform, and the tokens are used for paying for subscriptions, right? People buy subscriptions to access our products, right? So we're going to integrate the tokens and all the wallets into the product, right? So that, like, the people can pay for each access that they have on our platform, the token. So the other milestone is, the main reason we are running this ICO is actually to build an ecosystem around our product. That's the main reason, right? So we are focused on building projects. So our goal is like 10,000 projects that we have to build, right? And each quarter we have like 1,250 projects that we need to get built. And so we have like the project creators we need to incentivize to build these projects, right? That's like our main focus, like the building projects each quarter, right? So 1,250 projects each quarter, and as we kind of like go quarter by quarter, we will ramp it up. Right, and the way we'll ramp it up is, one, we will be kind of like expanding to new languages. We'll add Chinese projects, so there will be Chinese projects, there will be Russian projects. We have a lot of users from Russia, Russian speaking countries, so expanding to Russian projects, we'll be expanding to Portuguese projects as well. Right, so the first roadmap, we go into English projects. After we have covered English projects like three quarters, then we ramp up with projects in Chinese, projects in Russian, and projects in Portuguese. Yeah. And then after that ramp up, what we will be doing is like opening up our platform to all topics, right? So any topic that anybody kind of like wants to kind of build projects for, the person can build projects for. And that will be like in 2019. That's like, that's like our roadmap for that.
Great. Okay. And tell us about your tokens. What are the key benefits for your token holders?
Right. So the key benefits for the token holders is, one, I mean, besides people speculating with it. And,
sure. Besides it.
So number one is like, one, the tokens are used for all governance in the ecosystem. That means the tokens are used for making decisions. Right. And if you have like an education token holder, you can use it to vote which projects are created or not. Right. So you can use education coins to vote. And also, more important, which topics are added to the ecosystem. Right? Should we add topics X or not? You can kind of like, you know, veto it, or you can kind of like, you know, confirm it, yes or not, right? So they are using for making a like a decision in the ecosystem, right? So we kind of like use the tokens as a way to kind of like drive every decision in the ecosystem, right? That's like what we use. So basically, we are decentralizing decision making from LiveEdu team to the ecosystem, right? Okay. That's like what we are doing.
Okay, let's for a second imagine the negative scenario. If you don't get enough money, if you don't achieve even the soft cap, what will happen with the project and what will happen with the investors? Do you have any other maybe traditional sources of crowdfunding? Do you consider it?
Right. I mean, we'll continue building our project. And so the beauty of what we have is that we're not starting the project from scratch. Like, you know, just because of the ICO, we already have a product that we are building. That we started already, so we just continue on the milestone and build it up. But we're very confident that we will kind of like raise what we want to raise, and like continue to build our project like we have.
Sure.
On our roadmap. Yeah.
Okay. And anyway, what do you personally think about the future of the ICO market in general in the world?
I think it's very interesting, and I think it just needs more structure in terms of legal structure. It will help it becomes more stable, and for people to kind of like, you know, have confidence in it. But I think it's like a new market, it's a new like financing, new way of financing company, new way of building an ecosystem around a product which didn't exist before, and that's very powerful. And it's very new and nascent. It just needs time to kind of mature. But I think it will prevail because it's like it offers more advantage than going through other means of, like, you know, funding a project. Okay. You build an ecosystem around a product at the same time. That's like really powerful. So we have right now supporters in China, and supporters in other countries who are kind of like very heavily interested in our project, who tell their friends about it, who are able to explain the product to people that even we can't, right? They have their own way of explaining things that we find it interesting, like, you know, just watching it. Like be it on Bitcoin talk or other, when they kind of like explain things to people in a different way, or like, you know, explain the advantages and disadvantages of the product and why people use it and why people should use it and where it can develop. Mm-hmm. Right. So I find it really interesting. You build like an ecosystem around a product, and this is what the ICO market offers. I think it's gonna grow. It's just gonna have more legal tape around it, and which is good, because if it has legal tape around it, then it becomes like established.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So, and just in conclusion, in very very brief, in one or two sentences, why should I invest in LiveEdu?
Yeah. Why should you invest in LiveEdu? One, in terms of like. The product we are building is pretty awesome. It's awesome because we are building the future of online education, right? We are building like the YouTube for online education, and it's going to be a very, very huge ecosystem. And we are building the Steemit for online education. So Steemit is a multi-billion-dollar business. When they started, people didn't believe or trust them that they can build it. We are doing the Steemit for online education, right? So what we are doing is like the model itself is established, which is building for another category, right? And second, we are very established team in the space that we are in, right? And we also have like an established user base already of project creators. We don't have to search from scratch for new. We have 13,000 project creators we can start with, right? We can kind of like launch and like. So that's like, those are the three main key points that I'll say, right? So we have a very experienced team. We know the market we are in, and we are using like this ICO ecosystem that we are building around it, right? To build our whole product faster, to build our whole ecosystem faster. And yes, we are starting with 8 topics. It might look really small or niche, but it's not a niche. We are just starting with 8 topics to make it keep things simple. But as soon as we have launched those 8 topics, we will kind of like open up our ecosystem for all topics.
Okay, I see. Then Michael, thank you so much for this interview and for being with us today.
Okay, thank you very much.
Okay, so and I remind you that today my guest was Michael J. Garbade, a founder of LiveEdu. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and watch more interesting videos. Bye-bye.